Guys, we are continuing. I'll give a short introduction of bone. Okay, this is the structure of bone. We have upper end here, upper end, and lower end. Okay, structure of a small bone. Here is known as epiphyseal plate. Same here also, epiphyseal plate. Okay, this epiphyseal plate, this is a place where the growth, the increase in length of bone take place. Okay, growth of bone take place in this plate. And the other structure just behind, we use other marker. This place, it is known as metaphysis, metaphyseal plate, okay, or metaphysis of bone. This metaphyseal plate, you can see many MCQs regarding this place, okay. What is the importance? First of all, the all vascularization of the bone occurs here, means all blood vessels, they are present in metaphyseal plate, okay, highly vascularized. Means all blood vessels, okay, it is the weakest part of a bone, okay. For a bone, the metaphyseal plate is the weakest part. Okay, then I told you all blood vessels are present here. You know hairpin, how it will be bent and twisted, right? So girls used to pin their hair. So it will form a ring, a hairpin like structure due to the blood vessels. See, hairpin like. So imagine if a bacteria infect this side, this structure of the bone. This bacteria can easily hide here, right? This is already hairpin like, so it can spread the infection very easily. So it will be very hard to diagnose. It is inside, so it will make infection here. So this hairpin like structure inside causes infections. This can be a clinical question, okay? This hairpin like. Okay, for a bone. Then other important thing is, you know, in many children there is osteomyelitis. Okay, I told you osteomyelitis. Here I told you weakest part. So osteomyelitis commonly occur in this metaphyseal plate, as well as a fracture of bone. It is in metaphysis. Osteomyelitis in children. Okay, these are the importance of metaphyseal plate. Then we have, this is known as shaft of bone. It is known as diaphysis. Okay. So clear, this is diaphysis. So upper end, metaphysis, diaphysis, level, general picture of a bone. Okay. Now, we'll continue with the clavicle. Clavicle is the important bone in our body, okay? Already I explained you, the most common bone in our body likely to be fractured, it is clavicle. I already told, clavicle is the only bone common fracture. This common fracture occurs here. Medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3. See, common fracture will be taking place here. The medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3. So the point is very important. The fracture occurs mainly here, the medial 2/3 of clavicle. Okay, this is the structure of clavicle. And clavicle, it is formed in 5th intrauterine life, inside womb. 5th intrauterine formation in fifth, intrauterine life. And ossification, ossification means the bone will ossify, it will become strong. It is an eighth intrauterine life, okay? These are very important, helpful in many MCQs. You know, in our body, all long bones, they are placed horizontally, like this. So this bone, especially clavicle, this is the only long bone which is placed in vertical, okay? Sorry, all long bones, they are placed vertical. This is the only bone which is placed horizontal, okay? All other bones, they develop from membrane, okay? Sorry, all bones inside our body, they develop from cartilage, okay? This is the clavicle is the only bone which develops from membrane surface, okay? Usually, a bone will have only one ossification center. Ossification center means the whole bone will get ossified to a center. There will get ossified or get strong, okay? Clavicle is the only bone which is having two ossification center, okay? Okay, we explained the common fracture, the formation in intrauterine life, ossification. This is the first, which is the first bone in intrauterine life, which is the first bone to be formed. That is also clavicle. The first bone to be formed. Okay, very important points. Common fracture, of course, medial 2/3, ossification. Clear?
Yes.
Everything is clear? Okay. Then the difference between, I told you they have two ossification center. So there is difference between primary and secondary, okay? Primary and secondary. We'll discuss the difference between the primary and secondary ossification center. See, primary, it is before birth. I think you all are clear about ossification center, okay? Primary is before birth, is formed before birth. Here, secondary is after birth. It is only 1 or 2 in number. This centers, bone will be 1 or 2 in number. But it can be 2 or more, okay? And its primary ossification center, this is responsible for making the shaft of bone. I explained already to you what is shaft. That is a diaphysis part. Okay, this primary ossification center gives diaphysis and shaft. And the secondary ossification, this is for the growing part. What is that? Epiphysis, right? Epiphyseal region. It is present in both upper and lower end. I think you all are clear with these stuffs, what I told today. Okay, thank you for watching. Subscribe and share. We are briefly describing the structures present in scapula. We need this. We need to keep an image image of scapula in our mind. So in future we are studying many things, the attachments. So we need to clear cut definition, or we have to differentiate what are the surfaces. Okay, imagine this is our scapula. Okay, it is placed like this. This is known as the ventral surface and this is the dorsal. Ventral surface is also known as costal. Okay, remember this, ventral is also known as costal and this is the dorsal surface. See what are the structures present here. Okay, just this is the glenoid cavity. Keep an image in mind. Okay, this process is known as coracoid process. Okay, and we have, this is the spinous process. This is the acromion process. Clear? And we have angles and surfaces. Okay, or border. We have superior border. Okay, we have medial border. And this is the lateral border. We also have three angles. This is superior angle. This is inferior angle. We have lateral angle. That will be here. That is lateral angle. This one. Sorry. This angle. Will be lateral angle. So just an overall view of scapula. Okay, keep in mind this. So we have cavity, one cavity that is glenoid cavity, right? Three borders, superior, medial and lateral border. Okay, we have three angles, superior, inferior, lateral angle. Why we are studying this? Like in, for attachment of muscles and all, we will see the, from the superior angle of scapula. So we must have an image, where is the superior angle or where is the medial border. It is attached to the inferior border, sorry, inferior angle of scapula. So for, just for a understanding would, okay, so keep in mind this. Then what? We have three angles, borders, then the processes. We have three processes, very important, okay? We have coracoid process, acromion process, and spinous process. And I would like to add a high yield topic here, that is, I saw some MCQs, they are asking this spinous process, the root of spinous process is what, okay? Root of spinous process is from T2, thoracic vertebra, to second thoracic vertebra. It originates from second thoracic vertebra, as well as the inferior angle is in T7, 7 thoracic vertebrae. Clear? So keep all this in mind, okay? We'll continue the details, or we'll discuss this deeply in future class. So thank you for watching, subscribe and share.